Good morning, guys. It's currently 5 to 7 on a Saturday morning. Today you're going to be joining me on kind of like a journey vlog, road trip slash mum's 50th birthday party, family gathering today. So yeah, it's kind of a mix of everything. So yeah, it's literally just gone 6:56. So I don't know if you can see me in this light. Let me get this ready. Yeah, that's not going to work. Anyway, I'm going to start driving and I will join you. I will bring you back up with me on the journey. I live in South London, and my sat nav will always, while I'm using my phone, will always try and take me through central London. But I'd rather just come down onto the A2 to the M25. I think it's then onto the M23 and up from there. I just have no time for traffic at all, ever. So there's a speed camera, and I got caught speeding down this road before, so I better be careful. Oh mate, it's so early, my voice is croaky. Jeez. So in case you don't know where Hereford is, it is kind of on the verge of Wales, in the Midlands. So if you know like Worcester, Gloucester, Birmingham, well it's still like an hour and a half away from Birmingham, but it's kind of up in that direction. Do not follow my example of vlogging while driving. Right, so I've already missed my turn in for the M25 already. Little detour of missing the M25. I'm not actually sure that it's gonna take me my usual way. So I'd normally go, I have my pit stops on there, so all my little pit stops on the way. So I'll go from London to Reading, and then it's Reading to Swindon, Swindon to Gloucester, Gloucester to Ross to Hereford, and those are my little pit stops, my little markers of each kind of leg of the journey. I'm looking at this now, I think this is actually going to take me Oxford way, which isn't bad, like it's not bad, I know that way, it's no problem. But yeah, that's kind of gone out of my routine. I was expecting my bomb, bomb, bomb. Just gone past Clackett Lane Services, so I'm still in, I nearly said Syria. Surrey. So I've got to give a little shout out to my other half. I actually spoke to him the other day. He is a very private person and doesn't want to be in any of my videos, which is fair enough, and I totally respect that. Where I was calling him my other half, I don't want to call him my boyfriend. We've been together too long to call him boyfriend and girlfriend, and we're too old to be boyfriend and girlfriend. So it's my other half or my partner, because he is my partner of life. But yeah, I spoke to him the other day and I was saying, oh yeah, I did thank you, because he doesn't watch my videos. He thinks he's cringing. He doesn't want to cringe at me when he hears me speaking, because he says that he thinks that in my videos I speak totally different to how I speak when like in person. But actually no, I don't. I think in the beginning I definitely did, but no, not at all. Like seriously, I sound like a goofy little idiot. I have to give a little shout out to Billy.
They call me Billy.
I'm not allowed to say his name. See, this is the right. Honest to God, I've not got a flat tyre. Honest to God, I've not. Well, I don't think I've got a flat tyre anyway. Billy, I am now allowed to thank Billy. He came home last night, bless him, with a new Gorilla Pod tripod thing. It's a Joby. It's wicked, man. So yeah, thank you, Bill. Mwah. Love you, babe. I say a little fact about me, just something that I love. Maroon 5, Sugar. This song, Maroon 5, Sugar, is one of my top 10 favourite songs. Actually, top 5, I would say. Top 5 favourite songs in the world. It's just so chill. Just puts you in such a good mood. It's just brilliant. And the video as well. The video to this song is absolutely wicked. So yeah, love this song. So journey update, it is 8 o'clock. Is it 8 o'clock? Jesus, when did it get to 8 o'clock? Well, I was just saying, I'm 2 hours and 27 minutes away from my destination. But yeah, 2 hours, 27 minutes away from my destination, and it doesn't feel like.
2 miles at junction 16, use the left 2 lanes to take the M40W exit to Birmingham, Oxford.
If you've got any of that, let's get out the fast lane and get over just before I start causing a nuisance of last minute, because that was my mistake when I missed my original M25 get off. Song number two of this journey that is in my top 10.
Continue on M40W for 3/4 of a mile.
Can I speak? Yeah. It's another second song of the journey that is in my top 10 favourite songs. Chris Brown, Beautiful People.
In 1/2 mile, merge onto M40.
Fabulous memories, good bass. That's an all-round happy song. Of the journey. Katy Perry, Last Friday Night, TGIF, is another one of my top 10 songs. This again with Sugar is in my top 5 favourite songs. Definitely in my top 5, in my top 10, 100%. Again, lovely feeling, such a happy song, and there is a bit in it that really, 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 really reminds me of my dad so much. My dad plays the saxophone and he teaches the saxophone. He's amazing, honestly, and I am biased, but he is so, so amazing. He's so talented. I wish I had that talent. My dad's bit in the video, it's Kenny G that they've got, but this is my dad. Love it! Love it! So what I thought, because it's my mum's birthday, it's actually her birthday on the 12th of December, but she's having a party tonight. I thought for this journey, why not make a little playlist for mummy? So I'm going to play my little bits of songs that I have for her, and I'll just give you a little bit of a story why it reminds me of her. Some really good stuff, like, my mum's wicked, man. Well, all my family are wicked. My mum, my dad, my stepmom, everyone in my family are wicked. I'm very blessed to have such a wonderful, loving, supportive family. I literally, I'm a very lucky girl to have that.
You're such a big star to me. You're everything I wanna be.
So yeah, first up on my mommy playlist is Take That, Shine. I couldn't have started with a better song. So this is, I think if there were any specific songs that me and my mum could have, it would definitely be this one. If I had to say, right, gun to my head, this song is one of my mum's songs. For 100%, go and listen to the lyrics or go and read the lyrics. Everything that this is my mum. Honestly, she is such a big inspiration to me, honestly. We went to see Take That a few years ago when they were at Wembley on their, not Circus Tour, the one after that. And when this came on, there was nobody else in the stadium apart from, or the arena. The Wembley Arena? 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 Whichever. There literally was no one else in that arena apart from me and my mum when this song came on. Not a care in the world, just singing with each other. I will have to see if I can, there's a picture of me and my mum, we're just holding each other to this song. Because it's our song, it is our song. It's a creepy kind of trancey song, right? But I remember my mum, yeah, she loved this song. She probably still does love this song. And this was way back when you still had like your HMV. I know you still got HMV, but like proper HMVs and proper CD shops, right? And we traipsed all around London with my mum to find this CD. And oh. excited for a bit, and I get jacked up already. So I'm a bit of a sensitive one for this one. Let Her Go by Passenger. Compose, compose. So this reminds me of when I moved to London. This came out just as I was moving to London, and it reminds me of leaving her. And I know it reminds her of me leaving. So it was very sad, but it was also a journey in my life that I needed to do, and I've never looked back since, because it was the best decision that I made, moving to London, and I know she knows that, and I know she's mad at me for doing that. So yeah, so a bit of an emotional one, that one, but yeah, it's such a lovely song, and the lyrics as well. I definitely think of my mum to this one, and I know she thinks of me when she hears this song. So yeah, Passenger, Let Her Go, emotional one for me. So on a more positive vibe, we've now got S Club 7, Reach. Why does this remind me of my mum? Because again, we had each other. I say it like my dad's not part of this. Obviously my dad is a big part of my life as well, but obviously this is one song that remind me of my mum and my mum's playlist. So I will obviously do one for my dad as well, because there are so many things that remind me of my dad. So please don't think I'm leaving my dad out, because I'm not. This is just mum's playlist. So yeah, this reminds me of my week. At the time, I don't know why, but there just seems to be a whole load of family weddings way back when these sort of bands were around. And these lyrics. You got me so rich, but not. And we just used to sing it to each other and be happy with each other and just dance like lunatics all the time to this song. So yeah, this is another one that reminds me of my mummy as well. Hoku, perfect day. So I remember, I think my mum was going for a job interview. So I made her a playlist of songs to keep her happy, and so this song was the first song that was on that CD that will come on first, and the lyrics are amazing. I listened to it, just was that song. So yeah, anytime that mum's gone for a little bit of stress or a little bit of something, perfect day. Remember, perfect day. So I've just seen a sign that I'm in Warwickshire. Oh man, Volkswagen Golf GTD, love it. Love it! Hollywood, dance with me tonight. My mum is a tap dancer and she did this wicked tap dance routine to this song at my mum's friend's party. Mummy missed me, mummy missed me. And she's wicked, man. And I played it over and over and over, and my mum got so sick of it, right? So my brother and I, because we're little don't say the swear word, I don't really want to swear in my videos, but yeah, so we're little S's, we're little rascals, there you go, we're little rascals. My brother and I decided we would cover my mum's house in post-it notes. Post-it note stickers, we drew it everywhere, H2O on everything, because we found it so funny that she hated this song so much. Literally, she's got one of those big white American freezers. We got a whiteboard pen and wrote all over the fridge, at the fridge freezer, H2O in this whiteboard pen. Right, that stuff was on there for ages. We kept it on there for ages. And when it came to rubbing it off, yeah, my Queen Dolly. Me and my mum have a little dance routine too. So, right, this, we used to go. And then when it got to the chorus, we had a little dance routine. A little dance routine. We went to a place, but well, it's Bristol, everyone's probably heard of Bristol, but they have a balloon fiesta every year where it's like a big hot air balloon thing. So we went this one year, there was me, my friend Becky, there was Ollie, my brother Oliver, and my mum. I'll be back, I've got a call. It's still. So we went to this Bristol Balloon Fiesta, and we had a lady. Now, we called this lady Mrs. Harvey because she was drinking, is it that Harvey's liqueur stuff? I don't know what it was, but it was called Harvey's anyway, so associated Mrs. Harvey with it. And she was singing to this song when this song came on, because there was music in the background. And she was singing it, she was singing
everything.
And it was so low when she was singing it. So we were laughing and we just, she was such a nice woman. She was an older woman, but she was so nice, she was so lovely. And oh, this just reminds me of that day, because we cannot sing this song without going everything. Probably another little emotional one actually. Our city, not as much as Bloody Choir Like Passenger. Our City Shooting Star. Now this song, especially the acoustic version, reminds me of my mum. She was going through a very, very difficult time at one point, and I'd heard this song, and the lyrics are so apt. They literally are so apt or relevant to my mum, basically, to what she's going through. So I sing it to her. When you live the country life, you don't get buses. You have these things. These things. Hello, Hereford. I'm back. Oh, I've seen my stepmom. I've seen my stepmom.
Hi.
Hi. Hi. So guys, I kind of came in and said hello and did whatever, and my camera literally died as I walked through the door as well. So, doggies, we've got Belle.
Hello. No, show your face. Show your face.
Good girl. This is little Belle.
Little Belle.
Bailey! He's on his throne. Good boy. Hello, Bailey. Say hello.
Say hello. Yeah, kisses.
This is Lily.
Hi, Lils.
My new, what's it, Bob? What's it called? Tripod, look. Daddy's home. I just left my dad's. I'm driving to my mum's now. I expected traffic to be a lot worse than it is. I don't think it's actually that bad.
Here she is!
Hello!
She's a kid.
I don't want to squish her hair.
Oh, hello! Hello, my darling! That's doggies! It's doggies, doggies,
and the monkeys! Oh, Mr. Monkey Man!
Mr. Monkey!
That, by the way, guys, is the fridge that I was telling you about! Yes, let's see if it's still on there. That is the same one! Oh, is that the same one?
Yeah.
So we've got those still up there?
Yeah. But I'm turning it round because it was all on that side, because it was that way round, wasn't it?
So what was written on there, Mum?
H2O. All of it hit the bloody fridge and it didn't come off.
Beautiful kitchen, look at this. Suave! Suave! You know, on my journey down, and I was telling you, I've not prepped her at all, have I?
No.
Not prepped her at all.
I have a sneaky suspicion it may
be something to do with Dizzy Rail Squad.
Turn the bass up.
But it's not the same car.
No. Turn the bass up. Yeah. Bitch, dirty stinking bass.
Bitch,
dirty stinking bass.
Bitch,
dirty stinking bass. Dirty stinking bitch. Dirty stinking bass. Dirty stinking bass. Bitch, dirty stinking bass. Bass. I don't need no speed.
No.
I don't need no heroin.
No way.
I don't want no coke today. You can keep your cannon.
Yeah.
I'm a bassline junkie.
Yeah.
I'm a bassline junkie.
Yeah.
I'm a bassline junkie.
Tell
me again. I'm a lax funky.
Yeah.
I'm a feed for a big day bassline. When I hear one, I have a break time. I feel like a man's fool like a choir. I let the bassline take me higher.
Right, so we're going to find the, we're going to introduce you to the doggies. So we have Lola,
Los,
Lola, Oreo, Dermot,
Oreo, hello,
Wills,
Lucy,
and Dermot.